Speaker, it's a pleasure to follow the right honourable gentleman. He'll forgive me if I don't completely follow him, because we would never finish this debate. So I want to appraise the House of my view on this particular motion. First of all, this motion, as my right honourable and learned friend said, is not the motion that we have already voted on. This is a different motion. And I'm not going to make an excuse about it. It is a different motion. Now, the other side agreed it, so how they can laugh, I don't know. The reality is today, I am going to support the government in this. I'm going to do it for a very simple reason, that I think nothing huge has changed within the nature of the bill that is likely to come ahead of us, or even within the withdrawal agreement. But I do think what has changed is the balance of risks. And I think as politicians, not lawyers, as politicians, we need to appraise ourselves of what that balance amounts to, and therefore to what degree we owe ourselves to make those decisions. When I look at it, I recognise at the moment, since we had the two-week extension, we now face a choice about, therefore, what is likely to happen. Some of my colleagues do genuinely believe that there was no chance that if we vote this down, we go to the 12th, and that we will not get any extension from the EU. I just find that very difficult to believe. I think if one looks at what the EU has already said, Mrs. Merkel and various others, they really do want to keep the UK inside the EU. One way or the other, they would rather have us in, even if it's troublesome at the stage they want it. And I genuinely believe by the 12th we will be offered, or even demanded of, that is to say, we're given at least a two-year extension, which will require us to fight the European elections. And I don't know how I'm going to go onto the doorstep, having campaigned to leave the European Union, to support 17.4 million people, and then tell them, don't worry, we're not leaving right now, but we may leave a little bit later. That is simply inexplicable, and I don't believe genuinely for myself it is what I campaigned on or campaigned for. The second area that some have said is that actually it's all right because an extension doesn't really matter because we'll be able to stay in the EU and we'll be able to make those negotiations and get those changes, and we are in control because we have votes and we have an ability to take that control. All I say to them, I voted against Maastricht 26 years ago, and I've always maintained that we have never had real control. And in 40 years, if we had so much control, why are we here now trying to get out of a European Union that has extended its power and its competence year in, year out? Will you forgive me for one second? I want to make a point, and I'll give way but once, because, as Mr. Speaker says, we want to try and keep this short. So my point about this is I genuinely believe that the way to stand up for the 17.4 million is now to get to the bill. And I said to my honourable friend, who's not here in his place, from Stone, who I revere, as I said, in constitutional law. Here he is. I say to my honourable friend, Bill needs to get to the bill. And the reason for that is we will then look and see what of the Attorney General's issues that he raised and how he protects us is in the bill. What can we ensure is in this bill? And we can then still make a judgment about whether this bill represents what we believe is the way in which we should leave. And I therefore say to my honourable friends, they do need to consider this immediately. I give way to the honourable gentleman.
I'm very grateful.